Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Pokémon Colosseum. I'm gonna heal because I don't remember if we got healed after fighting Justy, so that's probably a good idea. Anyway, welcome back. Last time we came back here to Phenac City and took on the pre-gym challenge, aka we fought Justy and got the return TM, and we also discovered a little stuff about story and whatnot, but that's not what we're dealing with in this episode. In this episode, we are going to be taking on the Phenac Stadium. Now, I want to point out, I am still sick. I may have to pause a couple times to cough my guts up or whatever, but yeah, I apologize for the graphic image. But anyway, let's go into the Phenac Stadium. Hello, my friend. I'd like to take on this challenge, please. Hello, welcome to the Phenac Stadium. Would you like to enter the knockout challenge? Give me some info. The stadium battles are all played in double battle style, with the trainers pitting two Pokemon out each. You win the challenge if you defeat four trainers in a row. The challenge champion wins not only a cash prize, but also a TM, technical machine, with a Pokemon move. Let's go! Okay, so you will participate with the Pokemon that you have in your party now? Actually, wait, hold on. I do want to participate with our regular team, of course. But I want to switch them around a bit. We're going to actually bring Nico and Joey as the first two, because they're kind of a two old reliables. So, let's go. Please enter the stadium through the doors to the left or right side. Give it your best effort. I shall. Let's go. Any other posters around here? Nope. In we go. I love this knockout challenge, it really pumps me up! Rich Boy Flitz. What kind of a name is Flitz? This is bringing back memories, because this is actually one of the areas that's in the multiplayer mode, so yeah. Also, that is a Sentret. You brought an Azurill and a Sentret, I brought an Espeon and a Feraligatr. I think we know who's gonna win this fight, buddy. Okay, let's Psybeam the Azurill, why not? And of course, actually, let's put up a Rain Dance. Let's go Overkill. Let's see if we can do this. Took it down, okay. I didn't realize how easy these Pokemon were gonna be. I knew that they were all around level 40. Didn't realize they were all unevolved. But I think Joey's gonna decimate this place. Alright, Scratch. Ow. You did a lot of damage there, Sentret. Oh boy. Do you really have nothing else? You just had Sentret and okay. In that case, Nico's probably just gonna take this thing out. It will probably not even gonna need Joey. Okay. Nico solo run is what's happening here, I think. Okay then. Now, like I think I mentioned last episode, maybe I didn't. Also, I thought the victory music wasn't playing, but I just couldn't hear it over my speech. Unless it actually wasn't playing, I don't know. This episode, completely skippable. If you don't want to see pointless battles, you can probably just skip this episode. And also, we're immediately into battle 2. But, yeah. If you don't want to see this, you don't necessarily have to watch it. So, yeah. It's like Dragon Ball Z, it's a filler episode. Huh? I've never seen you around here before, big guy. But so what? Let's battle! Roller Boy Greb. I know, I'm gonna name my son Greb. I'm sure he won't grow up to hate me. Anyway. Tentacool and Doduo, some more Gen 1 Pokemon. Also, I wanted to mention this. When planning out this team that we're using, we still of course have one Pokemon left to snag for our team. And I do know what we are gonna be grabbing. It's actually changed from what I had originally planned, because I realized all of our teams so far are Generation 2 Pokemon. So I figured, why not try and make the whole team Generation 2 Pokemon? That gives away that the Pokemon I was planning to have as our last member is actually a Generation 3 Pokemon. When we get to it, I'll point it out, but to be honest, I decided against having that guy as our final team member, because when we eventually let's play Generation 3, I will probably use that Pokemon. So I guess a spoiler for a potential future Gen 3 Let's Play, but... yeah. So I ended up changing my mind, and I've chosen another second generation Pokemon, so... yeah, just wanted to mention that, because it's something I thought about last night. We're in the semi-final of round one already. Or the first challenge, I guess. Hello, you're excited. It must be my turn, I'm gonna try hard. You should probably always do that. Also, I like how she's like, it must be my turn, and she had to walk all the way out here. Psyduck and Pineco. Is that no music? Is that- hold on, I gotta turn this up, is that no music? Okay, no, there's music, it's just really quiet. I could barely hear it, okay. Psybeam- oh, I can hear it now. Do I want to no, he's bug type. I keep forgetting if bug is weak to psychic, but no, it's psychic that's weak to bug. So... maybe not the best idea to keep you out here, Nico. But then again, these things are weak as balls, so... I think I'm gonna Psybeam Pineco just because I want to see what it does. And let's slash Psyduck. Just to confirm my suspicions. It is neutral. Okay, that's fine because it took it out. Yeah. So bug doesn't resist psychic, it's neutral. Okay. Joey gained a bit more experience points. W slash! Go! Jeez, that Psyduck took that like a champ. Also, why is Psyduck so fat in this game? Like, Psyduck does not have that big of a butt. I'm just gonna throw that out there. I don't know why it looks so fat in this game. Also, I just realized, isn't Psyduck just pure water type? Because I don't think it got its psychic typing until it evolves, right? Or is it even part psychic? I gotta look this up now, hold on. Okay, Google. Well, it didn't work. Okay, Google. What type is Psyduck? Let's find out, shall we? Psyduck is pure water, and Golduck... is... also just pure water. Okay, I think I've always gotten that confused. Because they learn so many psychic type moves, but they're just pure water type. So that always kind of messes with me. Welcome to the final round against Rune. Oh, are you tense? Nope. You look pretty tense, you're like squeezing your hands. We haven't lost a single Pokemon to this yet. You have a Mudkip! It's a Mudkip! And a Zubat, okay. Zubat will be a no problem for Nico over here. Oh. And Joey's out too, okay. So let's see, let's Psybeam Zubat, and we will slash Mudkip. As much as I love you, Mudkip, I have to use Slash. I should take out the- yeah, with a crit, that's definitely taking out the Zubat. Bye-bye! Okay. Didn't gain too much experience from- oh, Joey's about to level up. Oh, you actually have more than two Pokemon, okay. You have a Cacnea. Hopefully you're not a Sandstorm Double Team Cacnea, like we fought in the last episode, because that was a pain. Mudkip, I'm sorry, you're so cute. Look at him. You have Tackle. You're level 42 when you have Tackle. Why aren't you a Marsh Stomp by now? Alright, let's do that. See if Nico can take out this Cacnea. Maybe... yes! Jeez. Nico is just putting in the finest in this Let's Play. And Joey goes to level 41. And this should take out the Mudkip. Yep, I'm sorry, buddy. You just only got to use one Tackle, but... what can I say? There we go. That's the final, guys. Feraligatr and- oh, sorry. Joey and Nico just ate that match up. Ate that whole thing up. Oh, you were only pretending to be tense. I wasn't tense, buddy. It's just my idle animation. Congratulations, you're the champion. Your battles were fantastic. The victory means you have won a lot of money. And as a championship prize, we've got to get TM18, which is Rain Dance. Now, we're gonna go in again. We're gonna switch up the team a little bit this time though. We are gonna go in with Hedwig and Donovan in the front to take on the second one. Because that went a lot quicker than I was expecting. Alright, of course, we're actually taking all of our Pokémon in. I just want to lead with those two so that they get to be in every fight. Here we go again. Battle 1. I hope it's not the same people. I don't think it. I'm pretty sure there's different trainers. Yeah, that's not the same guy as before. You're a little creepy looking, dude. You look Flanders. I'm gonna beat you and become the star. Guy Lang. Your trainer class is Guy. Also, your Pokeball pin is on upside down. Wait, unless it's an electrode pin. Actually, then it would still be on upside down. Yeah, whatever. Wingull and Igglybuff. Well, I have a Hedwig and a Donovan. By the way, I think Sean approves of Donovan's nickname. I'm not 100% sure, but I think he does. Alright, we're actually going to take down this Igglybuff. Using takedown. And I'll growl. Oh, my capture card disconnected. God damn it, we made it so far. And the attacks are currently going on, so you can't see what's going on. Someone, I think Growl lowered our attack. Hedwig did just over half to Igglybuff and got hit with a bit of recoil. Donovan, I think, is going to take this thing out completely. I'm sorry you can't see this. Donovan took down the Wingull. I'm trying to bring the footage back. Oh, this is terrible. Okay, we're at a time I can pause. One moment. All right, we're back. Wow. Oh, God. I apologize. I apologize for cutting out, and I apologize for my choking. Trust me. A capture card is, like, at the top of my list of things I gotta buy, so... Yeah. I'm saving that dollar for it, I promise. And to be honest, it's strange, because if you guys saw Mario Kart and Smash Sundays... Well, actually, Smash Sundays... Yeah, Smash Sundays came out yesterday. If you guys saw Mario Kart and Smash Sundays, it cut out, like, 3 or 4 times in, Mario Kart, and then didn't cut out at all in Smash Sundays. And those are both, like, 45-minute episodes, so I don't know why that is. But, whatever. The road to stardom is long. Yes, sir, it is. And also, didn't cut out last episode, and didn't cut out during either of the two grinding montages that were over an hour long. I don't understand my Elgato. I think it might be the cable, but I don't know. Well, I mean, it's broken. The actual capture card itself is broken. I've explained all this before. But I think the cable may also be on its way out. This guy's name is Bilal. Athlete Bilal. You don't look like a Bilal. Snowrun and Talo. Okay. Well, how about Hedwig and Donovan? I love these two. I feel like these two are the best of friends. Like, if you had to put the team together in pairs, Nico and Umbreon, but... Words, what am I trying to say? Nico and, Joey. I almost called him Fred. I don't know why. Nico and Joey are, like, best friends. And then Hedwig and Donovan, I feel like, go together. And then whoever shows up as our last team member is gonna be, like, complete best buddies with Tyson. But I don't know. I always send these two out together, I feel, so. And I always send Nico and Joey out together, so I don't know. I kind of like it like that, that they've got, like, these pairs almost. But down goes Talo. Absolutely no problem. As expected, because it's a Talo. And Snowrunt is gonna bite me. Or headbutt bite me. And you got staticked as well. Wow. Okay, let's Steel Wing so we don't take recoil damage, and Thunderbolt, and this should take it out. Boom! Oh, no. It's super effective? Is Steel super effective on ice? I am learning all kinds of new things today. Steel is super effective on ice. Really? Let's ask Google. Okay, Google. Is Steel super effective on ice in Pokemon? Let's find out. That didn't do anything. That just brought up a type chart. Let's take a look at the type chart. Steel. I'm sorry that this is a very unprofessional episode, but whatever. Steel type, blah blah blah. Strongest type defensively, with 10 types being not very effective against it, and the poison type having no effect. Poison has no effect on Steel? Also, what was that woman doing? Well, shall we get started? I don't know anything about Pokemon, do I? It lost its ghost and dark resistance in X and Y, dealing neutral damage. The steel type also has the highest average defense stat in the game. That doesn't tell me anything. Steel moves are super effective against ice, rock, and in later games, fairy. Okay. I didn't know that. I didn't know that in the slightest, to be honest with you. Like, I guess because steel isn't really a type I ever use, but... Interesting! Okay, let us... Oh, this might actually be well, not tough, but... Hedwig's gonna steel wing again. Wow, okay. Snubble. 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 I love Snubble. If you guys have seen Pikachu's Vacation, I love Snubble's voice in there. That's where I got the voice from that I just did. Snubble. Also, for those of you who may be curious, I do have Pokémon Sun and Moon. I have both games. I bought the dual pack. And I was under the impression, I read somewhere, that the dual pack had both games on one cartridge. Clearly that is not true, because it's just a cardboard box with both games in it. And some codes for some Pokéballs, but... I don't know where I'd read that, but that was certainly a thing that I'd read about it. But anyway, point is, I'm playing through them both at the same time, because I want to be able to get the version exclusives and stuff for each Pokédex. I think it's going to support Pokémon Bank, I would assume it does. And basically, I have not even gotten past picking my starter yet. I've picked my starter on both games. I picked Rowlet on Sun and Litten on Moon. I have not done anything with them yet. I picked the starters and then saved and turned off the game. Also, she just said there's no respect for her elders. Excuse me, I love my grandparents. Silly lady. Anyway, we're in the final already. But yeah, Sun, that's where I'm at with Sun and Moon. And I do want to play more, it's just, God, my life is so freaking busy. Anyway, I'm not letting a shady character like you win, that's rude. You look like me, you have my hairstyle, kind of, with the bandana and everything. Love Disc and Hoot Hoot. Well, I have a Noctowl. Somehow I think my Noctowl might win. I'm gonna exclusively target Hoot Hoot with my Noctowl, with Hedwig, because... Hedwig... I mean, look, have you seen Hedwig's eyes? She is pissed off at somebody, and I don't want to mess with her, so... That's just how this is gonna go. You have Surf. Okay. Boom. That did nothing. Donovan, eat it up. There you go. I love how Donovan doesn't even take one of his feet off the ground. He's like, I'm not going anywhere. Okay. You're putting up a fight, little Hoot Hoot. It'd be kind of funny if the Hoot Hoot targets Hedwig. Super effective. Down goes Love Disc. Not a problem in the slightest. Bye-bye. And what are you going to do, Hoot Hoot? Actually, you're going to have another Pokemon. You have a... you have a Treecko! So the last guy had a Mudkip, this guy had a Treecko. I'm gonna guess the next two people have a Torchic and... Probably a Pikachu, I don't know. Okay, take you down with that and let's see what a Thunderbolt does to Treecko, because... To be honest, Donovan has been doing really well against grass types. Like, he can Thunderbolt them, and it says not very effective, but it does, like, a ton of damage to them. And we got a crit on that. Hoot Hoot has fainted. I love how he looked up at the last second, like, why have you forsaken me? Alright, see what you can do. Not very effective. Still did half of it. Half of that thing's health. And paralysis. Donovan! Calm down. Alright, that missed. But that's fine, because Donovan is going to finish it off with another Thunderbolt. There he goes. Bye, Treecko. Whoa. That was kind of a cute animation. And there we go. These two didn't quite get the level ups that the other two did, but that's fine. Cool trainer Buna has been defeated. How could I lose to someone so shady? That is mean. Also, I realized in an older episode, I had said that we were attacked by some shady people. Hopefully the Nappy Nation don't follow up. Congratulations, you're the champion. Your battles were fantastic. The victory means you have... That's a lot of money! And it's championship prize, TM11, Sunny Day. And with that, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Pokémon Colosseum. Next time, We will be challenging the final two rounds, or final two battles of the Phenac Stadium, and finishing that off, and then we will finally be back to some story progression. I'm sorry that it's been a couple episodes of, like, optional stuff, but I want to take all of this on, and like I said, you can just skip these episodes if you don't want to deal with this, I guess. But anyway, that is going to go ahead and do it, so if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like, and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Look at that. It's going to annoy me so much that we didn't catch all of our team in regular Pokeballs, but oh well. Yeah, stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.